I'll never forget when he came to Fargo.
We did his workout in the bubble. We're driving back over to the facility. So I decided to ride with him in his truck, just get a little one-on-one time.
We instantly just hit it off.
We're driving back over and I just mentioned to him, hey, I appreciate the way, how he was handling the questions about how important his faith is to him. I just thought he handled it the right way.
He was quoting a scripture.
A Bible verse that was a favorite of mine.
I had it actually on my background on my phone as he was saying it.
He just kind of looked at me sideways.
And I was like.
And then handed me his phone. And I'm like, well, what are you handing me your phone for? Look at what my screensaver was. And his screensaver was that same Bible verse.
And I finished it for him.
1 Peter 3:15.
It was 1 Peter 3:15.
Always being prepared to tell others.
A reason for the hope that you have in Christ Jesus. It meant something special to me, and I'll never forget that moment.
There's a lot of Bible verses out there, and there's a lot of really good ones. The fact that our first connection, we hit on that note, I think it meant a little something to both of us.
It was a bit surreal, kind of gave me the chills.
It gives me chills to even think about it.
It's crazy circumstances that here we are working together again, and I'm pretty fired up about it.
Anytime we make a trade, we want it to be a win-win for both sides.
Honestly, I thought towards the end of the year, when things started going south there in Philadelphia, I thought, that probably never happened.
When we heard he was going to be available, we knew we would like to get him. We had started talking probably about a month prior to the trade.
About the possibility of being open to talk about it.
Philly had a point that they wanted to be at.
What's the compensation going to be?
We weren't going to get him at any cost.
What's the right way to go about this? How deep is our conviction about him as our quarterback?
We were going to be prudent in our thinking and in our process of how we were going to acquire him. It was a good exchange.
It took a while.
At the end of the day, we were able to come up with compensation that we thought was fair for both sides.
It was an up and down process, but I think we got to a spot where both teams felt comfortable.
Wentz throws, end zone, touchdown!
Wentz throws, passes, caught.
Wentz takes a chance, has his man.
They were giving us a quarterback that they had invested a lot in. I mean, we were giving good compensation back for the player because we believed in him.
It's just a natural fit in so many ways. I know Carson, I know Indianapolis. This just feels right to me.
A lot of excitement. Just so much excitement for us. That's the word I keep coming to. There's kind of some bittersweet moments, you know, leaving our home in New Jersey and kind of waving goodbye to Philly.
God, we just know that you're moving. We know that you're moving, and may we just be obedient to that. Pray for safe travels the rest of this trip, and then Hadley will adjust great to our new home.
I'm just trying to play dad, you know? I'm just trying to keep her squared away and have fun.
Thank you.
It's so important to me to have both my daughter and my wife with, because I mean, that's my team, that's my family, they're my everything.
It's nice to be back in that, you know, the Midwestern vibe a little bit for us. My wife's from Kentucky, so just it's very normal to her, normal to us. Heard great things about the community, great places to raise family and all those things. So we're excited for that, exciting just to be involved and invested in the community, get to know some people, and hopefully put on a good show for the Colts fans.
There it is, Peanut. Wheels down. We're home.
I get a pretty good connection with most of the quarterbacks that I work with. I certainly felt that from Carson on day one.
Man, so excited. So excited, can't tell you. Hey, and it's all in on you. It's all in on your toughness and your competitiveness. That's what it's all about.
Yes, sir, always.
I have a tremendous amount of belief, especially at the quarterback position, when he has a strong conviction about somebody.
Oh, it's really deep. It's really deep.
Welcome.
Thank you, guys.
I just felt like he got it, and like he looks at the game and plays the game the way that I think it should be played at that position.
What's up?
Good to see you.
There are some guys that you just know love the process. They love the grind. They love practicing. They love working out. They love talking football, watching, you know, everything about it. You're going to see it. The Colts Nation is going to see it. Like when they see Carson warming up on the field before a game, you could feel the energy. You can just feel the energy that he has for the game, for his teammates, for competing. My conviction is very deep.
Right here in the way.
What up?
How we doing?
Good. How are you?
Good to see you. You look good in that color.
Thank you. I've had this one for a while, believe it or not.
Coach Reich is an incredible man.
Super excited about getting to work with him again because I have the utmost respect for the man that he is, you know, the friend that he's been to me as well.
He understands the game. I mean, he played for 14 years. He gets it.
He gets it. He gets it from a mental side of things as a quarterback,
which just ultimately allows me to trust him so much more.
We talk about trust. Trust is important in every aspect, not just on the field, but off the field as well.
He was always the most encouraging person. I'd go in his office and we'd just talk life. We'd go on roll, and next thing you know, we were talking for an hour or two.
Whatever personal connection there is, it factors into the coach-player relationship.
We just had this connection. You know, we're both obviously men of faith, and we were able to talk about, you know, our values and different things. Like, it was natural.
It's always important to look for connections, both on and off the field, of ways to build relationships.
You have to be that much more intentional, and you have to really dive into to create those relationships both on and off the field.
It can be on different things. I mean, with Carson and I, you know, we connected on a faith level that was meaningful and tangible. With other guys, it could be something else. I've always believed that that's an important side to coaching.
It's crazy circumstances that here we are working together again, and I'm pretty fired up about it.
See the banners up there?
Yeah, I know.
Couple more we got space for. We got to get back on the AFC South.
2014?
Yeah. It's been too long. Too long.
Let's get back on the ship. Get back on top.
The deal is done. T.Y. Hilton is headed back home.
He's our leader. If you took one player, who is our emotional leader? It's T.Y. Hilton.
My God!
I'm home.
This is T.Y. Hilton. Let's find a way to get this done.
My decision to come back, a tough decision, but at the end of the day, I wanted to stay in Indy. Carson made me feel at home, you know, before he's even here texting me every day, just wanting to get to know me. That's really special, and he didn't have to do that because I was a free agent. So for him to do that, you know, it really speaks volume of his character.
Once we signed Carson, T.Y. was one of the first people I texted.
He texted me and said, "We got a special guy coming in Carson."
Remember that thing, all those years, that special thing you did with Andrew?
Andrew Luck going for a home run deep downfield, looking for T.Y. Hilton. Hilton makes the catch!
He would scramble and you'd make big plays down the field. I think that's about to happen again, if we can get you back here.
When he texted me that, and he was like, you know, this guy has some Andrew-like traits. If you can't get excited about this, then something wrong with you.
What do you think?
You like it? We gotta get you one, don't we?
The pieces are already in place around here.
We literally have everything at every position to take us to the next level.
Everything about the offense has me really excited. I'm excited to just be the guy that gets to facilitate the offense.
He knows he doesn't need to come in here and be a superstar. He's gonna make superstar plays because he has it in his body and in his mind to do that. Just run the offense and do your job. I have a quote in my office that's been in my office for 30 some years. The sweat of discipline and the hard work of repetition always precedes the thrill of spontaneity in any pursuit of life. Carson will produce some thrill of spontaneity moments, but what we will focus on will be the sweat of discipline and the hard work of repetition. Just do your job as a quarterback of this team, and there will be some pretty special moments.
This is the fourth Scout WrestleMania.
We needed to be together again.
Is this guy a blue card?
You can do him after lunch. And I gotta get at least 2 meals in before I see a West Coast guy.
Oh, I know that's not all right.
We want to grow our own players. We want to draft them. We want to acquire young players and keep them here as long as we can.
On draft day, we can take it.
That's it, we finished?
Not quite yet.
I'm just playing.